Good afternoon, kabayan. So, ngayong hapon po ay gusto kong i-share sa inyo ang iba't ibang bahagi ng paborito nating pagkain sa hapagkainan, lalo na sa almusal. Ang nakasanayan nating i-partner sa hotdog, ang egg. Alam niyo po ba na ang itlog ay mayroong walong bahagi? At gusto ko pong ibahagi sa inyo para at least meron magkaroon tayo ng kaalaman na ang simpleng itlog pala na nakasanayan nating kainin lalo na sa almusal ay maraming parte. Ito po ay kasi ang alam natin yun lang na eggshell, egg white or albumen at saka yung egg yolk. Subalit ito po ay technically speaking ay marami palang bahagi. Binubuo po siya ng shell, inner and outer membrane, yolk, vitelline membrane, air cell, chalice, at saka yung albumen. So, i-define po natin at lagyan natin ng konting paliwanag isa-isa para po maintindihan natin. Kaya nga lang po ito ay sa wikang Ingles. So, unahin po natin ang shell or ang eggshell. This is the bumpy and grainy in texture. An eggshell is covered with as many as 17,000 tiny pores. Eggshell is made almost entirely of calcium carbonate crystals. It is semi-permeable membrane, which means that air and moisture can pass through its pores. The shell also has a thin outermost coating called the bloom or cuticle that helps keep out bacteria and dust. Ang susunod naman po na parts ay yung inner at saka outer membranes. So, lying between the eggshell and the egg white, these two transparent protein membranes provide efficient defense against bacterial invasion. If you give these layers a tug, you'll find they are surprisingly strong. They are made partly of keratin, a protein that also in human hair. The next part is the air shell. The air shell is an airspace forms when the contents of an egg cool and contract after the egg is laid. The air cell usually rests between the outer and inner membranes at the egg's larger end, and it accounts for the crater you often see at the end of a hard-cooked egg. The air cell grows larger as an egg ages. So, sunod naman po ay yung albumen. So, yun po ang tawag dun sa nakasanayan nating puti ng itlog or egg white. The egg white is known as the albumen, which comes from albus, the Latin word for white. Four alternating layers of thick and thin albumen contains approximately 40 different proteins, the main components of the egg white, in addition to water. The next part is the so-called chalice. This is an opaque ropes of egg white. The chalice hold the yolk in the center of the egg. Like little anchors, they attach the yolk's casing to the membrane lining the eggshell. The more prominent they are, the fresher the egg. The next part is the so-called vitelline membrane. The vitelline membrane is the clear casing that encloses the egg yolk. And the last part is the yolk or the egg yolk. The yolk contains less water and more protein than the white, some fat, and most of the vitamins and minerals of the egg. These include iron, vitamin A, vitamin D, phosphorus, calcium, thiamine, and riboflavin. The yolk is also a source of lecithin, an effective emulsifier yolk color ranges from just a hint of yellow to a magnificent deep orange according to the feed and breed of the hen. So that's all folks for today. And sana po ay nakapagbigay tayo ng konting kaalaman or dagdag kaalaman doon sa simpleng pagkain na lagi nating nakikita sa hapagkainan, lalo na sa almusal, and that is the white egg. So, yun lang po at maraming salamat. So, huwag niyo pong kalimutan na mag-subscribe at pindutin ang notification bell para po sa mga susunod nating video presentation ay kayo po ay laging ma-update. So, goodbye for now.